because it's not an option.
It's not an option.
It's not an option.
It's not a tumor.
It might be a tumor.
It's not a tumor. Who is your daddy and what does he do? I'm Detective John Kimball. I'm a cop, you idiot.
Say hello to the camera. Ready to do this? Yes! Let's rock and roll!
Sometimes the world looks perfect. Nothing to rearrange. Sometimes you just get a feeling like you need some kind of change. No matter what.
Let's go, Soleil. This is killing our mojo. You have a cold?
No. It's like liquidy of it, you know, just from the wind.
So it's not those thick, chunky boogers. It's the quick release boogers.
Yeah, it's like watery, yeah. It's not even a booger. It's like a bit of a...
What happened? Are you all right?
The snowboarder lost control.
All right, guys. It's only about a 30-minute hike.
You bring your skins?
Yeah. Well, maybe if you push him, he'll get some pee on his ski.
Are you recording this?
Love, yes. Absolutely. Alex, flash your dick for the camera, buddy. Promise I won't post it on YouTube. The spring break edition?
Yeah.
But instead it's all guys flashing their dick of girls flashing their boobs.
Guys gone wild. Guys gone extreme. Don't trickle on my
To be honest, you've made me want to piss. Nice to get the body moving.
Sometimes there's a special for like $85, I think, or $89.
Okay.
If you buy it on the Scandinav website, you get access to Scandinav and the ski hill, and you get some discounts on food, whatever. It's actually a good deal because Scandinav alone is like $50.
Yeah, it is $50 alone. Wow.
So, and it's great, and you're guaranteed to go in because like there's a lineup sometimes.
So wait,
on good days.
How much is this?
Like $90 or $85.
And you get access and
the ski hill.
Call now in the next 10 minutes and we'll throw in.
Prepare to see what the life of a filmmaker is like.
All right, go ahead, guys.
Okay. Action! Action! Korea. It was awesome. Yeah.
The
perfect, just in general.
And then a bit just like beautiful, open, steep.
Amazing.
A little bit too much wind coming up, which slowed it up, but still it was incredible.
Chaîne de laine tête, là. Elle m'a dit, Ramat, oublie ça, ta crise de flingue mère, le gros. Est-ce que les patrouilles nous aimaient pas aujourd'hui, calice? Ça va être un solide caribou à soir, là. Mais hey. Quoi?
Ouais.
C'est stupide. What the fuck? Ça va être des crises de beast, là. Puis il drink, il continue depuis genre 9h30. Hey, 9h30, j'ai ouvert ma première bière, le gros, c'est pas simple.
Faut que tu te mettes à soir.
Showtime!
À soir, t'en closes.
Pair a year for 10 years and then you get too many, so the guy comes into the ski swap with 10 pairs he's offloading. This is just getting ridiculous. So I grabbed a pair off of him. I figured, okay, I can get a good pair. I mean, they're okay, but as soon as you go into, like, let's say 3 or 4 feet of powder, I'm used to just going deep, like, and the deeper you go, you just self-regulate. I've been skiing for a long time, and for me to ski in the powder, you go up. Actually, what it is, you go up, you get a bit of speed, you make your turn, then you go down, then you kind of slow down.
Oh.
And then when you feel yourself bogging down, you kind of lift the tips, and then you come up again, and then it's kind of an up and down, kind of, and every time you sink in, you get the snow
flying
up. Sounds
almost like a different sport.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. So I skied with these for like 10 years of powder at Fernie. That's where I was living for the last while.
Wow.
And then I get my new Salomons and I go skiing the powder with that, and they just don't sink. As soon as, like, you know, I try to dive the tip and go deep, but then like within 20 or 30 feet, like, it's back up again. And I'm thinking, like, well, that's weird.
Yeah, parabolics aren't the best in snow. If you ever try some skis that are fairly wide across, like a bit like mine, you know, they're straight, but they're just wide from top to bottom, and they don't have too much aggressive of a side cut. You kind of lean back on your ski and you float. It's really nice. And your heel still goes in, so, but your top, and you kind of, like, you know, you're always kind of floating in a sitting position. And for powder and steeps especially, it's fantastic.
Yeah. I
different.
Know that it's a, yeah,
it's, yeah,
it's a
different
thing that started.
It's just a different, the sinking up and down, it's not better or worse, it's just totally,
it's just how
sport.
I like,
yeah,
to do
exactly.
It. It's
just,
yeah,
a question of preference.
You know, and if I feel I'm going too slow, well, then I lift up a little bit. And then when I'm going too fast, then you just sink a little bit. And with these skis, I get that. But when I ski with my other ones, I'm just used to, and I do that. And then it's just like, whoop. It's like trying to sink a football. It just, as soon as you let go of it, it just comes right back up, right? And
yeah,
you grab it and you put it back down. It just wants to come back up. So I take a lot of heat with these skis, you know, especially out west. When I'm on a chairlift, everybody's looking at the skis, and then they land on this, and they, ah, ha, 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 you know, but I'm going, yeah, well, you know, with the powder we've got today, I'm sinking. Anyways, that's just my thing, and right now they're just too old, and they're way too, like, I have used and abused those skis for 10 years, 12 years, they're done. But they're now my rock skis, and...
Not a bad pair of rock skis.
No, they're not. And so early season, late season, you know. And I haven't skied here. Actually, the last time I skied here was in, like, March 96 was the last time I skied here.
Hasn't changed much.
No.
Well, the Soleil side wasn't existing. That wasn't there. I've never skied the Edge either. I don't think that was there.
No, there's no village, no gondola.
No, the gondola, yeah, that's new too. I never rode a gondola here. So, you know, I mean, it's
like a crappy version of Whistler.
Yeah, it's like Whistler.
Basically everything Whistler has, but crappier and smaller, and just not as good.
Whistler is that because you're so close to the coast, the influence of the Pacific is very strong, and you don't get that light, dry, fluffy powder. You need to come in the interior to get that. Absolutely. And for us in Fernie and the Rockies and Lake Louise and that kind of Rocky Mountain Trench,
yeah,
we
yeah.
call it,
it's
we refer to
snow.
That as West Coast POW, which is basically it's cement. You know, parking lots at 2,000 feet, and then it rains and rains, and sure, you get, you know, a strip of snow at the top, but it's just so humid and so
yeah.
wet that you
it's,
get
it's concrete,
it's
exactly.
like trying to ski through cement. But us, we ski at like 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 feet in the Reno, in the interior.
Drier. Yeah, it's fantastic. Yeah.
Like 1,000 kilometers away from the Pacific. So, I mean, we do get, you know, the moisture, the trade winds come from there, but we get more, we get the hitting of the North Pole and the West moisture, and then it falls in the Rockies in the lighter, drier stuff we get. So I don't have anything to do with Whistler, really. I mean, I respect it. I've skied there. You know, great place. But I've spent 17 seasons in Fernie. And
were you living there? I mean,
yeah, yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I moved in. It was like
from here.
No, I live in Ottawa.
Okay.
So I ski the Outaouais region ski hills.
Yeah.
So that's where I left in '96. Bumps. I lost my job. I lost my girlfriend. I lost my apartment. I said, "Fuck it, I'm out of here," and I just left to go on a ski trip. It was only supposed to last a year, and then I just came back last summer.
Wow. What did you end up doing in Fernie?
Oh, I did some construction, I did some landscaping, I did some ski bumming for like the first 4 or 5 years. I would only ski like 80 to 90 days a year. Then I got a job in a high school. I was doing some teaching, did that for a few years. Then I started up my own transportation company, so I was in the tourism industry. Then I was doing painting, some shuttle bus driving, I was doing some... apprenticeship, actually. That was the last thing I did. There was a company at Cooks Electric. They were looking for electricians, and I started an apprenticeship. Took me 6 years. Then I finished. And then the ski trip was over. I wasn't skiing anymore, really. It's kind of like a lot got worked out of my system.
Sí, creo que vamos. Creo que
yeah.
It's
amazing. Enough years go by, you know.
Cool, man.
Oh, but it was great. I mean, that fall '96, people were hiking up. It's the pre-season thing people do out there. You hike up the ski mountain.
Yeah,
for sure.
You learn the snow, you get in shape, and you
also
get, yeah, it's first track. By Halloween, I had already like half a dozen days of hiking up the ski mountain. And then they were supposed to open like the third week of the 29th, the main part. And November 96, they were supposed to open the chairlifts on that Friday night. It was on the day of my birthday, but they got like a meter and a half, and they just, no, we can't open up, we wait another week. So they
we
opened
come
on her birthday.
Hey.
So after we started dating, we were reminding ourselves about that all of 96, because we both arrived there at the same time, but she got the opener on her birthday and not me.
Uh-huh.
Right now, actually, tomorrow's their
was
closing.
It meant to be. It
wasn't tomorrow
meant to
is
be.
Their closing day, Fernie Alpine Resort, and right now their base is at 3.8 meters.
Yeah, same thing.
Yeah, just like here. Anyways, enjoy the ride.
Yeah,
thanks for the ride, guys.
Yeah, take care.
I want to see him on this one.